Hi everyone, and welcome to my channel. Welcome to my kitchen. Today I'm gonna spend the day working in here. I have a lot of mess going on here. Stuff that needs to be put away, stuff that I put aside for donating, stuff that needs to go outside for the porch. I need to put together my coffee bar. These totes here are for the garage. Food. Over here, I want to get this organized. I want to get that shelf painted. I picked that up at Target. I want to get the floors mopped. That shelf is black right now, but I want to paint it with Rust-Oleum charcoal paint and then wax it with white to make it look identical to my kitchen cabinets. I just have a mess. I would like to paint these terracotta pots. Most of the plants died in the freeze and I want to paint them, I think, white. I want to get them cleaned up and chalk paint on white. They are mildewy looking from just having water in them, for me watering them. They were originally for air plants. More food. The shelves aren't bad. That food up there is going to go on the new shelf that I have. It's the only shelf of food that I didn't have a Target shelf to put it on. But this is what we're doing today. First off is I'm going to paint. That way that the shelf has time to dry. Here's our little liquor supply. It looks dusty, so I need to dust. I'm not a liquor drinker, or maybe a margarita every once in a while, or a pina colada or a daiquiri or something. But here's our shot glasses from traveling. We always will pick up a shot glass, and I have it in just this clear glass. I guess it's a vase, if you will. So this afternoon I've been working on my shelving unit, getting it all painted, and I wanted to pop in and show you the products that I use. So I've been using this charcoal chalk paint by Rust-Oleum. It's $19.99 at Home Depot. It's not my favorite, but it is the product that I used when I painted my shelves in the kitchen, so I wanted to carry that same exact look to the shelf, so I went ahead and purchased more of that. I'm going to wax it with Waverly White Wax. It was $10.54. You picked that up at Walmart. I love to use these Scrub Buddy latex gloves from the Dollar Tree. And I also enjoy using these chip brush sets. You get two for a buck at the Dollar Tree. They work perfect. I got all my little pots painted for my window ledge in the kitchen to put my cactuses in. And then I just have already painted all the cabinets, all the shelves. So next step is going to be to white wax them, and then they'll be ready to go. Now I have waxed using the Waverly White Wax. You can see how much different the shelves look, and I don't need it to be perfect. You see right there, I wiped a little too much, so I actually lifted off the paint. But I love the, like, distressed. And you can see the cardboard underneath here where I'm painting. That is the actual cardboard from previous shelves that I purchased. I just keep the cardboard. It's perfect for painting on. I put a little bit of a wax on these very sparingly just to knock them back just a little bit. I use these rags. I just use a little bit of wax with this rag, and then I blend it with this rag. They're old rags. I use them time and time again, and just the way I do it, it makes a big difference. So now I can put this cabinet back together, or put it together rather, and start organizing my shelves in the kitchen. I cleared everything from this area, so I have it all swept. And now I'm going to mop. I love to walk on fresh mop floors, but this is what I use for my mop. This smells amazing. Gain scent. Oh, so great. I'm not sure where I got that at. Since it's such a big bottle, I'm betting I probably picked that up at Walmart. But I'm going to give this area a good mopping. And then I'm going to wax the other side of my shelf, which when I showed y'all that video clip that you just watched, I saw I was ready to put it together. I forgot I had not flipped it over and painted and waxed the other side. So that's what I'm waiting on. And you can just see, look, my poor plants, they just all froze to death. Some made it and some didn't so much. And I gotta work on my coffee bar. It was all decked out for winter. And now we got to flip it. I got my new shelf here with the rest of them. Cleared off all the contents so I can get it reorganized. At Walmart, I purchased this easy liner and it's large enough to be able to, I can cut it in half and then line each shelf so that I don't knock off the paint. And then I have just my groceries down here. I don't know if it looks organized to y'all or not, but I got it by category and I'm gonna spend the next little bit getting all this food on the shelves in an organized manner, which is the fun part for me because I love to organize. All the food organized on the shelves. Here I have vegetables and beans and tomato products and I don't know, all the different things. So got everything just organized up. This little guy makes me laugh. He's an alligator potato masher. He's super cute. I got this shelf cleared out. The food that was up there, I put on the new shelf. So now I want to take my cookbooks from over here and put over there so that I can put some of my Princess House that's way back there that you can't see in this area right here. And that way I'll have three complete shelves with all my Princess House stuff. And I'll have room to buy a few more pieces at the thrift store, of course, because that's just the best way to buy Prince's house. Today is the day that I'm gonna send these items that I've decluttered to the thrift store. This is 124 items from around my house, from my bedroom declutter, from the attic declutter, and from my kitchen declutter. I have those boots that I showed in my last declutter. I took them out and now I'm going to donate them. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. Here is 25 Estee Lauder items. Brand new perfumes, brand new all kinds of stuff in there. But I'm just not going to use them, so I'm going to let them go. Here is some items from the attic declutter. Some winter items. More attic declutter. Lots of declutter going on at my house. And I'm so happy to be able to send these to the thrift store and allow someone else to get some use out of them. A stack of books that I just don't match my style. And I'm gonna let those go. Some kitchen items. Here's some vintage items that I've picked up. They just don't match my style right now, and I'm good to let them go. Decluttering is so freeing, and I'm just glad that I'm getting to this. I think I have about 550 items within the past year that I've donated to the thrift store, And once you get started, is just awesome. I mean, you get to see it go to somebody else. You've enjoyed it. Now it can go to someone else and they can enjoy it. And it's just a good deal. Here's some bags from my last shopping trip. And I will put all the stuff in these bags. The good thing about these bags is the thrift store can reuse them. They can put other people's purchases in them instead of going to the landfill. I'd pop on here and show you the dog's setup after dark. So I created him this little eating area here in the kitchen. And it's dark in the kitchen and he gets thirsty sometimes at night. And so I did a little hack. I got solar lights and put them here in the kitchen for him. I purchased these solar lights at Target several years ago. They were 75% off, so they were $5 a box. And I just put the solar pack here in the window so it can charge all day. And then at night, we have a little light in the kitchen for the dog. Can come and get him a drink of water anytime he wants to. Hi, sweet friends. So today is the final walkthrough in my kitchen, a refresh. I have decluttered in here. I have wiped down all the cabinets, rearranged some things. So I thought I would bring you along and show you the changes that
Change I made in here is I added an additional cabinet. These are from Target. I've showed y'all these. I painted them. I showed y'all me painting them, and it has just really expanded my food storage. Here is what I have stored on top. This little gator is a potato masher that I got at King Dollar several years ago, and I just really like him. Some new plants. That little gold basket is from the Dollar Tree. I made some changes here on my shelving. That one really didn't change much, and neither did this one. But I did add the little angel. I bought her at the thrift store. This shelf changed quite a bit. There's some thrifted items there. And this shelf changed. So I like that. Coming around to my stove, I have this marble slab with some decor on here. I like that. I have not replanted my succulents, but I did get all the little planters painted. They're all chalk painted and a white wax. I did end up going back and having to paint on the inside of them. At first I was not going to, but I did. Here is my air fryer on its marble slab. That has worked out tremendously. Underneath, the air fryer gets really hot and it was melting my shelf liner. I got a new crock for silverware. I added this pitcher that I picked up at the thrift store. I have all my sponges, dish soap, and a soap dispenser here by my kitchen sink. A little changes going on in this area in my spices. I moved some things around on that shelf. And then this shelf is where I had the food that went on the new food storage shelf. So that is all changed. And then up at the top is some John Deere and some tart tins that I put in those vintage ball jars. Those stayed the same. Coming around above my sink is this window. And I did a little changing up there and clearing out. This little ice crusher was my grandmother's and it is always hung right there in the same spot. I put a fake air plant in it. A little declutter on that shelf. Rearranging. I added that Dollar Tree Enjoy the Ride decor. I spread out some of my Princess House because I gained an extra shelf here when I decluttered and moved things around. Gracious sakes alive. I love that little sign. I picked that up at King Dollar several years ago. I made this some time back. It's a marble rolling pin, and I put a rolling with the homies. Some Dollar Tree decor, and then a boxwood in a vintage milk glass bowl. Some honey and spice, like hot sauce in that. And then a Princess House, a napkin holder. That the napkins actually are from the Dollar Tree. They are for graduation. I picked those up last year for two for a dollar. Two packs of napkins for a buck. I love them. Coming down, I made some changes here. I used these Dollar Tree bins to hold my Rubbermaid type plasticware, my Tupperware lids. There's some more. There was just slight changes there. I did previously show y'all the dogs area. Coming around. Some decor hanging on the door. Went for a little less is more look here on the kitchen table, the breakfast table, if you will. I picked up these placemats in North Carolina at a thrift store, and some little vintage napkins. Some plants from HEB. I love those. Here's my inside plants, my little plant corner. These are the ones that survived the freeze. A little wreath that my mother made for me many years ago. I love it. Some of my John Deere decor, some sunflowers, and last but not least is my coffee bar drink station. Chandelier. Here is the coffee bar drink station from the side view. I have some plants from HEB and a little snail. He's super cute. I picked him up at the thrift store. A caterpillar. A quote from Johnny Cash. This morning with her having coffee, when asked for his description of paradise, I turned on the light for the chandelier. Picked that up at 90% off. I believe it was $5 at Hobby Lobby. So anyway, guys, that is it. That is my kitchen refresh. I have tried to pare down. I am a minimalist. No way, shape, or form. I love all the things, but I have definitely tried to pare down my collections and all my things. If you have enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button. Become part of my friends here on YouTube. And y'all have an amazing day. See you in my next video. Bye, guys.